What's up, guys? It's your boy Ariel back with another video.
Today, we're going to be building an RC rocket plane.
But first, you may be wondering, Joel, what are the ingredients for an RC plane? And how do you make one? And why? Why would you make one? Well, I'm glad you asked. Here are the ingredients. First is PLA. The next ingredient is a spray can to spray the plane. Next is tape.
Next is wood. Next is our finest screws. And lastly, there's even more tape. Now alone, these ingredients are nothing, but combined, it makes a soup. It makes a meal. It makes a full course dessert. And today we're going to be mixing some of that dessert by strapping rocket engines on it. Now you may be asking, Joel, you don't sound very responsible enough to be doing this project. And what I say is, yes, I'm definitely not responsible enough. Sue me. Actually, please don't. I'll go broke. So here's the game plan. The plan is I'm going to print the main body of the plane, and then I have an old wooden plane model that I can take the wings and the tail from, just insert it into the body I print, and then I will have to make a tail, but after that it'll pretty much be ready and be ready to have a rocket engine strapped onto. So. Okay, so basically the main body just finished printing. I actually think it looks pretty good. There's a slot for the wing and a slot for the tail. I'm just gonna put in the wing and the tail and we'll see if it flies. Okay, so I just put on the wing and the tail. Let's see if this puppy flies. Bruh. Okay, attempt two. Last time it decided to quit on me, so I gave it a tumor to increase its center of balance, so hopefully that should help.
Ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
Okay, so I found a better place to launch from. It's from a tree, and the leaves will stop the wind, which will help the RC plane with turbulence, and on top of that, there's grass right below, so we'll have a nice soft landing. So I decided to launch it from there, and also I added a cardboard tail fin, so hopefully it should go more straight. Alright, let's launch it.
It was at this moment that he knew he messed up.
Okay, so after it flew, I realized what went wrong, right? So the center of balance is right here, and the center of lift is also right here. And basically what happened was the nose cone was too heavy and the tail was too light. So it literally just plummeted straight down and it couldn't do anything because the center of lift was just so light. So what I'm planning to do is I'm going to put more weight from the nose cone and that should equalize it. So. Okay, so I took a little bit of weight off the nose cone and it flies pretty much perfectly now. It's close enough. Okay, so funny story about the rocket engines. Basically, the plane decided to be a little bit goofy, and if we put the rocket engines on that plane, it would combust. So we're gonna be using CO2 cartridges instead of rocket engines. Now we just have to wait for them to arrive. Okay, what's up guys? Sorry it's been a while. I made a little
airplane launcher right here, and basically this will just go down the track like this, and then it will hit that spike, which I'm gonna put a CO2 canister in that, and then it will rappel up and then fly away. So yeah, let's test this puppy out. Okay, we wrapped a green leaf around the CO2 canister, so hopefully it won't fall out now. Okay, so I modified the RC plane, and basically I got a little straw, and it just goes right over the CO2 canister, and then when this part of the nail hits that part right there, it will just go right into the CO2 canister, burst, and fly away. So let's try it. Yeah. Oh.